To poor Jews like the Zinger family, World War I brought typhus and hunger and split up the family forever. From 1917, Isaac, along with his mother and younger brother Moshe, lived in Biugoraj in the Lublin district. After that, he was a teacher of Hebrew for a short time in the little village of Yadovo. But even in the provinces, echoes were heard of great political events, of social movements, and the intellectual ferment in the Jewish community in the big cities.
Łódź, Wilno, Lwów, Kraków, one odgrywały bardzo istotną rolę w kształtowaniu intelektualnych środowisk żydowskich. Warszawa chyba największą rolę w sumie, choć Wilno z nią rywalizowało. Ale jeżeli ograniczymy się już tylko do Warszawy, tutaj działały rozmaite stowarzyszenia żydowskie, intelektualne, artystyczne, Związek Pisarzy, pewien ewenement w skali światowej, penklub żydowski. W zasadzie penkluby są dla kraju terytorialne, ale w uznaniu odrębności specyfiki kultury żydowskiej powstał odrębny penklub żydowski.
No, Warszawa stała się ośrodek tej kultury na całym świecie. Na przykład i podstawa tej kultury, na przykład czasopisma. W danym momencie w Warszawie, w okresie międzywojennym, mogła pani pójść do kiosku i tam sobie wybierać wśród między, zależy w jakim roku, między 3 i 5 gazety dzienne, dzienniki w języku jidysz. I do oprócz tego tygodniki, miesięczniki, no cały świat literacki w języku jidysz.
Jewish filmmaking developed. Theater too, but also sport, popular music, non-religious education, and a readership for non-religious books and newspapers. Literature takes the lead in three languages. Many young writers choose to write in Polish. Creative writing in Hebrew develops on a small scale, but the chief phenomenon is the blossoming of literature in Yiddish, no longer just a slang dialect, but a language of culture. The books of Sholem Asch are acclaimed in the literary world, as are those of the Literarische Blätter generation, a group of literary rebels among whom the elder Zinger plays an important role.
To już było następne pokolenie po Perecu, po Sholem Aleichemie i po Mendele Mojchersforim, którzy nazywają się w Jidysz die Klassiker. Te trzy klasycy, tak jak w Polsce są klasycy, jest też trójka, to w literaturze jidysz jest też taka trójka. Zinger przychodzi pod koniec tego całego pokolenia i podstawowy jest wiedzieć, że jego brat Israel Joshua, Israel Jehoshua Zinger, starszy od niego, już był znany autor.
He's not religious anymore. He doesn't go to the synagogue. He doesn't put on tefillin. So as far as Jewish religious practice goes, he, as his brother, as all the writers on Klamatsky Street in the Writers Club, with very, very few exceptions, they were agnostics and secularists. They did not practice Jewish faith. However, Bashevis is a little bit different. You see, the first cracks in his enlightenment, in his critical realism, are beginning to show. The same writer who just said yesterday, we are condemned to the facts and nothing but the facts, is still the son of a rabbi from Krochmalna Street. And not just any rabbi, but a rabbi who was a mystic and believed in miracles. So the son comes back this way to his father's world, right? In a very roundabout way, through modernism.
On na przykład nie uznawał żadnego pisarza żydowskiego. Miał jednego, Zeitlina. On był przeciwko Aszowi. On był przeciwko Segalowi. Nikt, żaden pisarz żydowski nie był dobry.
In 1923, my brother Joshua became co-editor of the literary journal, Literary Pages, and the mail brought me the news that I was given the post of proofreader. The literary pages was radical, socialistic, half-communistic, full of bad articles, poor poems and false criticism. My brother soon turned away from the editorship. Literary Warsaw was dominated by the communists. A great number of young writers and readers believed that communism would once and for all put an end to the Jewish problem. In the communist order, there would be no Jews or Gentiles, only a single united humanity. Religion and superstition would become the things of the past. Neither my brother, nor even less I, fitted into this kind of ideology.
Zinger był bardzo inteligentnym człowiekiem. Sensem humoru nadzwyczajnie. Można było z nim siedzieć miesiące i nie nudzić się. On w Polsce, w Warszawie pisywał powieści nie pornograficzne, ale takie z dalszy ciąg nastąpi jutro. I każdy odcinek skończył się tym, że podniósł nóż i...
This part of Tłomackie Street was home to a legendary institution of Jewish Warsaw, the Jewish Journalists and Writers Club. Everything that was at the heart of the spirit of Warsaw's Jews was here. In today's seat of the Jewish Historical Institute, the only surviving building of the famous street, rabbis and Jewish religion teachers were trained for service all over the world. The Judaist Scientific Institute and library were located there. Opposite, where the blue skyscraper now stands, was the Great Reformed Synagogue, a place of worship and cantorial music concerts. A few hundred feet away, at 13 Tłomackie Street, secular, even heathen life was thriving.
Na Tłomackie 13 przyjechali chłopcy i dziewczęta z całej Polski z talentem literackim. I tam zaczęli szukać uznania. Tam się dyskutowało o roli świata. Tam budowano socjalizm. Tam budowano komunizm. Budowano tam syjonizm.
All of Isaac Bezhevis Singer's life concentrated around the club, his professional, social, and erotic life. It was here that he met the young communist Ronja Poncz, his first informal wife, the mother of his only son. They went their separate ways. He would meet his son only after 20 years.
Everything has got extremely complicated, but I needed these complications and looked for new ones. In the literary club, I met one of the girls who were humorously called literary supplements. They would come to the club to take part in the literary and journalist gossip, meet the writers and have secret affairs with them. Sometimes it turned out that the girls, and there were a number of married women among them, wrote poems in Yiddish or in Polish. Some of them were inclined towards Zionism and wanted to leave for Palestine. Others were communist sympathizers who might one day illegally get to the Soviet Union. Some of them came from wealthy families, and literary Don Juans would receive small loans from them.
Róg żydowskiego, on nie miał żadnej formy języka. Każdy język żydlaczył, prócz takich. W żydowskim tak, dialekt warszawski. Taki, że można było ramiona otworzyć, to było tak jak warszawski Żyd mówił po żydowsku, to tak jakby ten język był biblijnym językiem. Ja nie... Jest szczęście, że nie wiem, że nie pojmuję, co się stało. Bo gdybym pojmował, to bym nie mógł żyć. To bym szedł na dachy. Myśmy tracili nie tylko naród,